Coming up, we speak to Sdra, who are using Microsoft Azure for a sustainable approach to running their cloud infrastructure. Customer Tech Talk starts now. In today's world, maintaining a sustainable approach to business is something that everyone's looking at, and no more so than in the forestry industry. I'm joined today by Cristian Brolin, Chief Digital Officer at Sdra, who'll share how they approach moving their infrastructure to the cloud. Before we speak to Cristian, let's take a look at their video.
Sdra is a forest company based in southern Sweden. It's a co-op and it's owned by 52,000 members, which all own their forests. Sdra helps our members to facilitate their forest throughout the life cycle, and our mission and goal is to maximize the value from the forests. In addition, Sdra has industrial plants where we produce timber or pulp, and certain side products like electricity, which we sell to the grid. Sustainability is in our core DNA. Sdra wants to be a leader in the journey to a climate-neutral way of living and conducting business. Our members are very proud of their sustainable forests and wants to pass this on in the best possible way to the next generation.
Cristian, thank you so much for taking time with us today.
Thank you for having me and giving me a chance to present our journey to the cloud and the Azure ecosystem.
Now, Sdra has a long history dating back to the 1930s, so I can only imagine the types of legacy systems that have been built over this time. Now, I understand that a lot of your journey into the cloud started with more of your productivity toolset and Microsoft 365. Can you maybe take us through a little bit about how you started and more specifically, how you got to the point of wanting to migrate your infrastructure into Azure?
I certainly can. There were many driving factors, but there were one thing which actually led us to decide and make the, for us, bold move. We were using Microsoft 365 as one of the first customers in Sweden. After a period of time, we decided and opted into using Dynamics 365. When that happened, we realized that all our files using PowerPoint, Excel, Word, using the Microsoft 365 was stored at Microsoft. And also all our transactional data in Dynamics were processed at Microsoft. Then I figured out, why do we have all data with Microsoft, but the servers somewhere else? And I came to the conclusion that I wanted to move the processing part, i.e. the servers, to Microsoft Azure. And that's why we did it.
Now, when you made this move, you really started this entire journey in partnership with a company called Cygate. And you know, this whole process was beneficial for both parties in the relationship. Can you maybe talk a little bit about how you worked through the migration and what the benefits were for Sdra as well as for, you know, your partner Cygate during this process?
Certainly. At that point, Cygate was the one that held all our servers here on-prem in Sweden. And I felt that we need something to work together on, and they need to learn how to use cloud platforms much better, and in particular Azure. And I wanted a new ecosystem which would provide me the best possible tools for our future. So I partnered with Cygate and I said, why don't we do this together? We don't know exactly how to do it, but we will learn from the process and we both chip in all the energy we have and we make a success story, which we both need, because then they can find new partners and new clients where they can move to the cloud. And I get, you know, a freebie almost to the Azure ecosystem. And it turned out to be great for both of us.
That's really great to hear. And awesome to hear too, that, you know, you could kind of, like I said, not only help Sdra, but also help Cygate to kind of move into this new world as well and expand their business from just doing hosting into also being able to provide those migration services for their own customers going forward. Now, you know, when we were going through the planning for this interview, you mentioned that, you know, one of the driving factors behind this migration wasn't necessarily the cost savings, but it was really something else that helped you drive that move to Azure. Could you talk a little bit about, you know, what the driving factors were and how that's helped your business and also your IT team?
Certainly. You mentioned before, Ben, that Sdra is a traditional company starting in 1938, and we have had a lot of different pieces of software and obviously the legacy associated with that. I wanted to take a new standpoint and have a new baseline where we said we want to have the absolutely best ecosystem where we can provide agile and fast services from. And Azure came to mind, obviously, based on what we just said before. And that's why we did it. A similar way of explaining this would be that we wanted to be, you know, on the speed train going somewhere as opposed to be on a slow train. I want to have the best possible tools every day to develop secure, fast applications to our business. And certainly being in a very highly developed ecosystem, which continuously evolve, is very good for us.
That's so great to hear and awesome to hear how you're continuing to take advantage of those new services as they become available as well. Now, when we had a look at your intro video, you mentioned how important sustainability is to Sdra and specifically how that's really built into your DNA. Now, that idea of, you know, having a sustainable cloud provider may not have been a contributing factor on your initial move to Azure, but you know, since that move, you've kind of had that pleasant surprise on Microsoft's commitment to sustainability as well. Can you maybe, you know, give us a little bit of an insight as to, you know, how you've seen that and why that's important to Sdra specifically with your business?
I certainly can. I think I would come from two different aspects in my answer. One is that, as we said, for sustainability is part of Sdra's DNA, and I found that it's the same for Microsoft. You provide very good technology and you still strive towards to be climate negative, in fact. Same as us. Secondly, I also think that in my mission as the CDO of the company, I need to come up with very good solutions to always provide the best sustainable tools to our business. And being in an ecosystem with new and fast tools that provides me this service is also added benefit.
So really great to hear that Microsoft Azure can continue to provide you all of that great functionality while still providing a service that aligns with, you know, your goals and your focus on sustainability as well. Now, your migration has been relatively smooth along the way, but you did have some challenges you faced when you were moving your systems over to Azure, whether that be from older versions of software that you had to deal with, all the way through to, you know, helping to bring along some people on the journey within the business, so that they could actually help be feel comfortable to move ahead. Could you maybe share some of the details of those challenges and how you dealt with them?
We had two different problems, I would say, when we finished the project, which we learned from. One was that we decided very early to do a lift and shift to be sure we weren't dual-homed for a long period of time. And we thought that we could move all Windows servers to Azure. Unfortunately, like most other companies, certain Windows versions that we run are quite old, and obviously we couldn't move those. We hadn't planned for that, and that became a problem. So we've been continuously upgrading the old Windows platforms to new ones and then continued to move to Azure, of course. The second one was that even though we have very competent and highly skilled IT staff that were very confident that this move was going to work perfectly, as we discussed the different risks, we started to touch base about those risks with the business. And then they became nervous, which then caused a problem for us. So I think next time, if we do something similar, we need to confine the risk discussions to IT people only.
So that's really interesting to hear, especially when you think about the fact that, you know, the IT teams were the ones who were probably a little bit more risk adverse than others within the business. But as you said, you really kind of took the initiative and brought them along the journey with the business to, you know, help ensure that everyone felt comfortable moving forward. Now, as you think back over your time on Azure, what are some of the lessons that you've learned that you would share with others who are maybe looking to migrate to the cloud or perhaps already started down that journey?
Well, there are a few things that we learned. One was that we didn't properly do a correct assessment when it came to the lift and shift of the different Windows versions that we had deployed. Obviously, Azure cannot accept the oldest Windows versions which are around, which naively we thought it could. So that's one lesson learned. So I would advise everyone, just please check that, you know, anything you lift and shift is able to run on Azure. The other risk we had when we started the project was that no matter how much we, you know, we counted and used different tools, we were slightly always unsure about what the landing cost would be on a monthly basis. What we learned was that it's actually quite low. So we actually get more value for money after we landed in Azure. Finally, I would say we find Azure to be very stable. It's working great for us, and we're quite confident now that 6-7 months later that this is going to continue to work, and we're very happy with the services provided.
That's so great to hear, and some great lessons there as well for others who are looking to make that move. Cristian, thank you so much for taking time with us today. It's been so great to hear how Sdra is moving forward and pushing their business forward with the cloud, but still maintaining your commitment to sustainability, especially in parts of the business where maybe this isn't a concern of others in the past. So great to hear and awesome to hear how you're doing this.
Thank you, Ben, and we're very happy to be a partner of Microsoft.
Of course, if you want to learn more about anything you've heard today, or if you want to start your own Azure migration, you can head over to Microsoft Learn to get started. Microsoft Learn has resources all the way from the fundamentals of Azure up to developing your own HoloLens applications. It includes things like certification prep and also interactive TV shows with Learn TV. Microsoft Learn has all the resources you need to reach your goals at your pace. Of course, we're always looking for new stories to feature, and if you'd like your company included on a future episode of Customer Tech Talks, you can reach out to us at cttalk@microsoft.com to get started. And make sure you follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn to keep up to date on all the latest episodes that are coming out. Thanks again, and we look forward to seeing you on the next Customer Tech Talks.